Shornhorst.
Yeah, this is.
I'm sorry. Yeah. This is. Yeah, Shornhorst. Yes. Mm-hmm. Yep. I said it, and I'm like, did I get the right name?
You did it. Did it right the first time here on Marshall Blucher Day. Oh, there we go. Now they've taken us live. Happy Wednesday evening, everyone, and welcome to Wednesday Night Warfare. I'm giddy. I'm actually a little bit giddy. I've been telling the crew we've got. Well, first of all, let me say who's here. Good evening, first of all, Velker. How are you?
I'm well.
Good to hear from you. Hey, Ron Dalinore over there. How are you?
Vive la France.
Vive la France. And we also have our special guest, Auditor and Kibitzer. Did he leave? Did Mike leave?
Nope.
Oh, there he
is. I'm here.
We gained John Stanley Law.
We gained John Stanley Law. So it's great to have everybody coming by to
chat. I'm stalking tonight.
Awesome. And we have Mike coming by as a guest of honor. He's going to sit on the couch right next to me like Ed McMahon. Yes. Yes. That was an excellent use of your hussars. Yes. But I was telling everybody that I'm actually a little bit giddy. Oh, before I start into this, I got to send out my tweet. I can't forget. I've been forgetting lately that I got to make sure we're live broadcasting. I think we are, because otherwise Red will yell at me. I don't want Red to yell at me.
You are live.
All right. Well, that's good to hear. And so that just means I need to be able to share a link.
And it looks like John Pfeiffer is the first in tonight to say,
hey,
say hi.
It is John. How are you? Always good to see you, John. And we're going to say it's live. So why am I excited? Why am I so very, very pleased now that the tweet is out? Why am I so very, very pleased that we're doing this? Here's why. Somebody over in Europe, I gather an academic, I'm not sure who, just got a wild hair and decided that today, of all days, a Wednesday, would be a great day to try to get the hashtag Marshall Blucher trending on Twitter. And through the intervention of a lot of academics in Europe, and I certainly did my tiny bit, and a whole bunch of others, we actually got hashtag Marshall Blucher into the international trending of Twitter around the world. Now, I'm sure there's a whole lot of people out there that went, wait a minute, who? But it is so super cool that that got done. And then to wrap it all up, people said, well, you in America, we've been doing it in Europe, you've got to carry it forward. I said, well, it just so happens, we've got a Blucher game tonight. So we do. Here it is. It does involve Velker versus Dalinore. This time, we've been playing the Scharnhorst campaigns, this one on the southern Germany, the Bavarian map. And the fight is between Velker's Russians, there they are, and Dalinore's French. There they are, not a surprise. And the battle, for those who remember, is between these four flags. And we determine victory in a couple of different ways, but one of the first and most important is on victory points. We got to see, as these people were maneuvering into position, which one of these little towns and villages and cities were they able to seize. I see over here that Velker grabbed Frischbach, which is worth 1 point. I see also over here that he grabbed the inelegantly named Niederheim, so that would be a total of 3 for him. Over here we have, ooh, that's French, we're not going to worry about that yet, we're going to get there. So I still see 3 for Velker. And then I think we see some on the table itself. Here he has initially, and we'll talk about that in a second. That's a big one. That's Karl's Corner, Karl's Eck. That's 3 points, so that's 6 for Velker. And that is Kaltenbach. So that is 7 for Velker. All right. So what does Ron have? What does Dalinore have as the French? Otherwise known as the good guys. Over here we have the field of, we have the mill field, Mühlenau, which is 1 point. We have Wunsberg, which is a point, so that's 2. Let's see, am I missing any others? Looking around.
I don't think so.
So, 7-2. So, looks like our guy Dalinore has some work to do. So, 7-2, that's a big lead for the Russians in the early going. We also see that their guys are almost all, both armies, unlike our previous battle that we saw between OJ and Zeke, where there were a lot of reinforcements. Not a lot. They all seem to be facing off against each other. But oh, over here, I see some Russians, so we don't know who that is. And they're going to be trying to come in a contested sector. So that's going to be a little trickier. It makes it a little harder for them to come on. So let's see what we've got by way of a battlefield for these fellows, because we had to build one. Usually Velker is my number one helper as we try to build battlefields, but he couldn't be here for this one because he's playing on it. So instead, We had to call in his mom, Mercusa, who would join us. And over here, oh, who's that? Whose picture do we have? It isn't Sean Connery for once. It's Blucher. He's watching, so that's pretty cool. There he is, the marshal himself. Forvets. So here's the terrain. Remember what we just saw? Remember we talked about Velker's forces? Well, there they are. Turns out they're a bunch of saucy Cossacks.
And cuirassiers.
And cuirassiers. And then these guys back here, these fellas in the back, they're the ones that got sent out on recon duty early in the Scharnhorst campaign. We're going to have to take a look and see what happens to them and just how tired they are as they walk on the field. But here are the corps. Here's, remember, we saw Velker was in control of this town, so he's going to get to deploy all the way up there in Kaltenbach. You know, he can deploy all the way up to that line. That sector is pretty much his. In addition, he's going to get to deploy down here. There's Karlsruhe, just like we saw it on the map. And there are some few extra features that got put on. There are some crop fields that got added. There is this little forest that got added. And finally, Velkerheim.
Because of course.
Because everywhere in Germany, there appears to be a area of habitation known as Velkerheim. We can't necessarily speak to its particular size. All right, so how are we doing? How are we doing over here? Whoa, the chat blew up. How did... Daniel, I will ask you later how it is you managed to get bland from all these things. Good Lord, man. All right. Why is my stream not live? I want my stream to be live. There it is. Let's get all the way over to what we're actually doing. Excellent. Because I'll be able to watch the crew. All right, so let's talk about how Blucher gets prepared for a game. We've already got our stuff done, so let's talk about how Scharnhorst sets up the game. We've already had the battle. It will be remembered that Velker declared our battle, so that's going to put a little bit of obligation on him. We've already put in the terrain. Gracious me. We have set up our mandatory terrain. We have our terrain choices. A lot of good stuff like that. Here we go. Victory points, VPs, on the Scharnhorst campaign maps are found in the urban areas. Village is 1, town 2, and a city is 3. We already knew that. There is a... okay, very good. All right. So what we must needs do is place a terrain, a marker, one of these objective markers, right here in Kaltenbach. Flip that over. That was a mandatory. And it belongs to the Russians, sorry.
No, I'll take it. That's fine.
I figured you would.
No.
And and we got to put one over here, too. Because we know that belongs to the Russians. So there's a couple good little objective markers. All right. And now... prior to setting up your army, both sides must place one additional objective marker. Okay? You must place this only in one of your table sections, not in a neutral or enemy-controlled section. You may not play it in a mandatory urban area that was already set up. And you may otherwise place it, you know, you can place it pretty much any place you like. They have no value in VPs. They only count if the game ends at nightfall. That's when they could matter. So, how many do we have left? We got 2? Yeah, we do. So, one for you, Ron, and one for you, Velker. You got to place it somewhere in an area you control. Velker, remembering you control this. You control this. Ron, remembering you control all 3 of these. And that, except for this area here, this section from here to here is kind of a no man's land of 12 inches. So you got to place that marker somewhere in your area. It could be here in the trees. It could be here in this field. It's already done. Velkerheim is an objective. To the shock and surprise of no one.
Velkerheim is an objective for Velker.
All right. How about you, Velker? Where's your objective? That crop field? Must be a very significant crop field. Very good. All right. Now it is time to return our recon cavalry to the board. Oh, I'm sorry. The player who declared the battle, that's Velker, he must set up first. You must set up all of your units on their correct sections. All units may be set up with prepared markers, although if they are, there it is. They may be set up in urban areas as garrisons. Sub-commanders, remember, begin off table. And no unit may be set up within 6 inches of a section border that borders an enemy-held section. The player who declared the battle plays the first turn. So, Velker, you're up, remembering again that you pushed forward into this area. But this area and this area are, as I say, something of a no-man's land. So it's up to you. Set them up. Yes, Jacobite Rising. Now somebody's got to make Jacobite Rising figures appropriate for the 75 for Tabletop Simulator. Then I'm in. We will do it.
I'm sure they won't be too long in coming.
I hope not.
Of course, some people will say, well, that's just Command and Colors. I refuse to play.
We don't listen to those people.
Those people are silly. They don't matter in life.
And they don't even like Cheese Whiz.
Hey, at least it's better than some people, you know, running a gaming store that don't actually play.
Right.
Or, I'm sorry, gaming website. Gaming,
you know, people that run a fairly well-known True. Gaming website that don't play games. Ah, those Russian guns. You gotta love it.
So, Falco, do you have an excuse why you're attacking me?
You have a motivation?
I have a motivation.
Do you have?
Velkerheim has been stolen from Velker himself. That means it must be taken back.
Yeah, that I think he's got a pretty basic motivation. He's coming to get Velkerheim.
That
back.
Is true. I have a motivation against these Russians.
What's that?
They cracked their eggs on the wrong side.
Oh.
The guns in the bushes.
The guns in the woods. Guns in the weeds. Just remember, you got to poke their nose out.
Yep, it is poked out.
Good.
These guys are scary. Even though those guys are even scarier.
I was gonna say that's the scaries face the scaries. I don't know.
It's the guard versus the guard, right?
Mm-hmm.
Still, yeah, it's still a view, right?
You know,
those guys kind of in front of him,
he's
still got a good view.
Oh, yeah. Yeah, you know, it's he's got to have a half a base width.
Yeah, he's got to have a base width.
All
right. I think that's everyone.
All right. Ron, you're on. Set him up. Remember, you got to stay. This is the only place where you've got a restriction. This area is across 48 inches, give or take. Therefore, it's 24. Therefore, from this spot... I can do it easier this way, actually. Yeah, pretty much you got to stay this side of the river. Make sure you don't have to be back further than that. Forgive me.
No problem.
It's 24 is halfway, so it's 6 more inches. Yeah, that's exactly it. Almost.
That's
well
exactly
done.
It.
Well done.
Nice.
That's your limit. Got those? I don't know. Velker's got these guys right behind you. They're looking at you.
I see them.
They see you. And Velker, you'll recall you don't place your sub-commanders on the map. Alright, you took Kutuzov. Naturally. Oh, see, the French do have somebody else that can do the gun thing.
Yes, sir.
And everybody's taking that legend ability. Well done. Significantly increases your morale.
Good.
You both have it.
Yes. Good for me, not for him, though.
Hey, Red. Good to see you.
Oh, definitely good for me.
Red came in and gave us 3 exclamation points. I totally dig it.
Okay, Jim.
All right, there we go. The return of the reconnaissance cavalry. All those guys you sent out to recon now have made it back to the battlefield just in time, albeit fatigued. You may set them up in any of your table sections. You roll a die as you place each one. On a roll of 6, he gets 2 fatigue. On a roll of 1, he gets no fatigue. On a roll of 2 through 5, he gets 1 fatigue. So let's...
This will be the time where I want to roll low and I'll roll high.
A lot of sixes. So who wants to go first place in the horses?
Dalinore can go first.
All right, Dalinore. Actually, I think I take it back. Velker, you should probably go first. You declared the battle. So who do you want to do? You got the second Hussars and the first Hussars.
The second Hussars will be over here.
All right. And you could place them anywhere in your sector. You place them on the battlefield. All right, they're right there. Let's roll for him and see what they got. 1 die.
Why is he so close to the river?
Aww. I have double checked. He is in the correct place. So you got to roll for the second Hussar Brigade.
Yep, the second. And this one. It'll be right here.
All right, so.
Where's our rollers?
We have at least. Oh, we don't have extra rollers? Oh my goodness. I have failed. Blucher frowns on me. There's one there. And we'll put yours over here on because you got a lot of trees on the other side. You got a roller, but no die. There you go. So, Velker, 1 die 6 for the first 2 stars?
One
die 6, yep. You want it, you're checking to see how tired they are.
Ah. Oh.
They are at a line 5.
Did I lose one? Did I roll badly?
No, the perfect roll is a 6.
So that is badly.
No, but 2 to 5 is 1.
Oh.
Just don't want a 1.
Oh, okay.
I thought it was a 6 you didn't want.
Is that right? Let me look. Oh, yeah, you want a 1. Sorry. You want a 1. A 6 is 2.
Close, no.
Yeah, you were very close.
No,
right,
Velker, you want a 6.
Yeah, right. Now you must check for the second Hussar Brigade, Velker. That's also a loss of 1. So they're not too terribly tired. That's usual, I would think.
Yep.
All right, Ron, you're up. 1 at a time. Let's place them. Ooh, skulking in the trees, 2nd Dragoon Division. They're not too terribly tired. How about these guys? How do they feel?
Not good.
Ooh.
No, you're aiming for 6s now, right? You want 6s. 6s are good, right?
They're a little tired. They were a little tired. Oh, they're not so bad.
Oh,
what?
Dude.
Oh. Exactly the same. Oh, almost exactly the same rules as before. 4, 6, 2, 6.
Oof.
So your hunter gatherers, your seekers, they wound up in a bad.
They
order.
Are very tired.
They are most fatigue. That's true.
And then when I need those 6s, they're not going to come up.
That's exactly it. All right. So now finally, the last thing we got to do is calculate the army breakpoints. Which is pretty simple. What we're going to do, we're going to count all the infantry and cavalry. And half is your number. All right. right, so let's start with Velker.
1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 8.
Correct. Your morale is 8. And look at that.
What?
8.
What?
How about you, Dalinore? What do you got? Let's count them.
Here we go. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17, 18.
Ooh, a morale of 9. Now, usually, folks watching at home, this would be 1/3, so it would be somewhat less. But both of these gentlemen have chosen the legend trait in one of I think it's in both cases your commanders in chief.
Yeah.
Napoleon has legend, and so does Kutuzov. So they're both legends, and they result in them getting half their value in. Now, bear in mind, eliminated artillery units, not those that retire, but eliminated artillery units do count towards that number. So even though they don't count, so it's a tricky thing to keep them alive. All right, well, Velker, you have the first move. This is 3 mo dice for both armies. These are 300-point armies.
That's kind of nasty.
So it's the old school. It's.
I'm going to turn print off.
Yeah, if we haven't turned print off, we now must. Let's do a quick verification that we're going to have darkness over here. We do. Good stuff. Gentlemen, I wish you all the very best. We might as well call it the fight for Velkerheim. Velker is first. Ron, please give him some mo dice on turn one.
Sure thing. Good luck, Velker.
Thank you. You too.
I'm ready.
Show the folks at home the number. Velker, you're off. All right. Beginning with core activations.
Right? Yep. 3 inches, right?
Mm-hmm.
Right.
Jim, core fields are rough, right?
Correct. They do not block line of sight, but they are rough terrain.
Crop fields?
Yep.
That's them.
That's 4. Can he keep going?
Yes, he can.
Away you go.
That's 4.
Ooh. Yeah. Now, the other thing you can do, and I would think you would do it, is you would plunk down. Oh, do you have that? I forgot. He's got the legend. Kutuzov actually should be off the board because you plunk him down where you want to.
Okay.
He can only use his abilities. What's it? Oof. He's immobile. But anyway, you don't have it. So, yeah, that's 4 points. 1, 2, 3, 4.
And now the guard corps.
Very good. That is your guard corps. Away they go.
And not only did they take Velkerheim, they also sneezed in my coffee.
How did they get close enough to sneeze in your coffee?
That's what you have to ask them.
Just remember, Velker, that as you start
never see this coffee.
Whittling them down, you don't have to carry the bodies as far to bury.
True. Ian Hamilton would point out you are safe to bury them right there in Velkerheim.
That's a good point.
So you move them up.
And now these guys.
Wait, back up. They're not in the same core, so you got to check. Oh, yeah, they are. They're all guard corps. You're right. My apologies. Well done.
How far do cavalry go? 12?
12. 12 on a straight.
I'm going to back them up a little bit so they don't get hit in the natural blast. How far are we away? More than 6. Awesome.
6.
The guns can move 3, right? Or what?
No, guns move 6.
That's guard.
Total your number and ask.
That is 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, plus 4, 12. May I continue?
You're done.
You're done, mister.
I figured, knowing Dalinore's luck on Blucher.
Yeah, I was gonna... This is one of those places where Ron's luck is going to work for you.
This cannon here is not guard.
Oh, he's not. Oh, thank you. Good point.
So he's...
And you're still done.
You're still done. All right. So he moved up. He stayed still. All right. Do you have a shot you want to take? Any long balls you want to throw out there?
I don't think so.
Got a ton of guns.
That's a good point. No, it's not worth it right now.
All right. So there's no gunnery. There's obviously, I don't think there's any musketry because you moved. And there's obviously no melee. So that's it. We go to turn two. The morning is proceeding as one might expect. Will you please give Ron some Mo Dice? Mo Dice are had. Yeah, that's not a shock.
Yeah.
I could have moved them on. Oof.
No, no. You know, if you want to move your subs on, you can. What he's doing is he's moving his CNC because when he uses Napoleon as his first, he uses excellent staff work, which lowers the cost. You can move your subs. If you want to attach your subs to somebody, go ahead. It's not going to affect the outcome. Just do it now because then they're stuck there. Your subs are stuck there. Your CNC bounces back and forth.
Do you have to add your subs at the beginning of the turn?
Yes, you're supposed to. They should be your first move. To the shock and surprise of no one. Yeah.
Wait, Napoleon's better than Kutuzov?
And that adds one artillery to him.
Well, you can do one of two
what?
Things. You
oh,
can
that
do
idiot.
He can do
no,
one.
No, no, no.
You can do one of two things.
Lay the guns plus one to
why
ammo when
I
attached.
Have that, huh?
Yeah, or you can resupply the gun. But yeah.
Why can't I have him? I'm the one with the big guns.
Don't you have somebody that's got artillery?
No, I don't.
Oh, okay, well.
I thought I read in the book with the lay of the guns, it automatically adds a plus one.
It does.
If the gun shoots. Right, if the gun shoots, okay. I misread it. I know what you're talking about. Okay.
Yeah.
I'm thinking something different. Okay. I thought it meant it added like another five to it. That's what I thought.
No.
Oh, anyway.
He's still wicked powerful. Jeff, I'm going to tell you right now, and you can write this down, I'm predicting it, we will never see Commands and Colors Pike and Shot. I don't think it ever happens. Breaks my heart, but I don't think it happens. What you doing over there?
Doug will be oh so unhappy about that.
So what are you doing?
Trying to figure out how to get rid of my ruler.
F1.
Wow. No, I haven't played tabletop before.
I was going to say, how long you been doing this, man?
All right, that's 1, 2, 3, 4, 5.
Yep.
Oh, well, that only cost
two. Well, remember, it only cost 2.
I'm assuming I can still go.
Yeah, because he rolled 3 dice, so I don't know how you get less than 2 or less than 3.
All right, going over here.
Mm-hmm. So folks know this is the old guard.
Oh, they have the bushiest mustaches.
They do. They do. And they have to have the curly cues, too. They're very lovely. We don't spend enough time this close in the videos, do we? Really appreciating the fact that most of us, I won't say all. Some of you are great. Don't get me wrong. Daniel Moreno is an incredible painter. You should all check out his stuff. But most of us don't paint this well. Look at that. Look how nice they are.
The majority of us don't paint wonderfully like
we're getting to play with much nicer figures than most of us would have. Poking your face out the trees, are you?
Are you visiting that my face hole?
All right, so that's...
Oh, no, I pulled a Fletcher Pratt. I can't use my ruler. That actually came to mind. Like,
that
oh, no,
is
I used my ruler.
Sick.
I'm not supposed to do
that. That is...
Yeah, that's six.
Six. Yep, six. Velker, how's he doing?
He's all right.
Keep going.
All right, we're going on to the right flank.
Mike, this is shaping up to be much more straightforward than yours.
Yep.
What do you mean, how come Dalinore is the French tuna? When is he not the French?
You know?
There's a joke in there about him being a plumber and having to deal with waste and things like that, so it makes sense.
All right, you. That'll be nine, Velker.
Nine? Velker?
Yes.
Nine. Can he keep going?
Nine, you may continue.
Whoa, boy. I forgot what he rolled.
I rolled well for your Dalinore, that's for sure.
Yeah, I guess.
Eleven.
What'd you say?
11.
You may continue.
I am stopping.
He's done. What was the number?
It was
12. Uh-huh. All right. You got any, I don't think you got any cannon shots.
Yes.
Your gun
Yes,
moved.
I do. Yes, I do.
That gun
No,
moved.
My gun did not
oh,
move.
Oh, that gun did not
no,
move?
No, it didn't.
Oh, yeah. Dude with lay the guns did not move. Yeah, boy. Yeah, this
what
guy.
What other guns were you looking at?
This dude, by the way, for those who don't know, he's the guy, he's the young guy that tells Napoleon in the movie Waterloo that he's not accountable for his guns. He's the guy that Napoleon yells at in that famous scene right before the battle. So it looks like you want to shoot, huh? Straight at you got to go. You're outside of canister range, so you can fire at whoever you like. With him, it's six dice plus a bonus.
One hit. Yeah, see, now the low rolls go.
I'm going to make sure if you even get that bonus or if you get a second die. I forgot.
It's a heavy gun.
Yeah, heavy artillery.
Heavy gun is a bonus. It's a bonus.
Yeah, it's a bonus. Yeah, so that's what it got you. So that's what it...
How do I look at his roll? What?
Just look at the chat.
You rolled a 4 and a 5, so that means he gets a plus 1 from lay the guns.
No, plus 1 gives him an additional die.
Oh.
Right, I only got one hit on him.
Yep.
Trying to give you more hits.
Yeah, you're nice that way. Okay.
So I appreciate it, but
his alarm is set. Gun is fired. The gunfire is recorded. All right, and there is no musketry. And
nope.
There is no melee. So that's turn three, please. Jamming through the morning. Ron's giving you some mo dice. Let me have a peek at him.
All right.
Velker, your move. If you want to place your subs, you should do it now.
All right. Nikolai, he's going to go right here.
And you should stick him behind him, because, yeah. Raevsky. Ooh, very interesting. Okay.
All right. And then I will have my guard go.
Guard begins.
How far away are we? This guy is going to prepare.
Oh, really?
I see your big old horsies over there.
I don't know what you're talking about.
What horses? I've never heard of those.
So forgive me, Velker. Who did you say was preparing?
This guy's preparing. How far away is this guy? making sure that I'm all out of range. Yeah, he's good.
I'm all out of range and nothing to
that. Cannot believe you are going to do an air supply riff.
It just popped up.
What is the matter with you?
Really want to know.
Parents raised you wrong is what it is.
He's not even... I don't even think he was alive when that song came out.
No. No.
When did it come out?
Oh, I'm all out of love? That's got to be, what, 82?
Yeah, I was 10. No, 9.
What? That makes you 48 years old?
No, 21. 17 years experience.
You need to work on math, my son.
Wait, did he say 21?
With 17 years experience.
Wait, what?
1980. You're pretty close there, Jim. No, that's when the song came out.
Because we're getting demands at home.
I'm calling. Talk about you, Dalinore.
We're getting demands from the home audience for explosions, so we're going to give them some explosions.
Oh, yes, explosions. Explosions.
The Russians get some explosions. Let me come over here and give the French some explosions.
What was that?
Explosions. All right. Alright, so Velker, you moved one, or you activated 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, correct?
Yep.
How's he, did you move this gun? Did you want to move this gun?
Did I move that gun? I believe I did. Did I?
You had, no, because he stayed put, you couldn't have.
Oh. Was he up to back-to-back last time?
I don't recall, do you need me to roll it back?
No, don't roll back.
I'm sorry. My wife was talking to me. What were we trying to
do? The question is if this gun battery moved. I was not looking.
No, this gun battery did not move.
No, you know why it didn't move? Because I was wondering whether it had a shot here.
Oh.
Yeah, that's where he is. So do you wish to move him?
I do not.
Yeah, he has a shot.
All right, so 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. How's he doing, Dalinar?
He's doing okay.
Keep going.
All right, now... First core.
All right. Noting that this guy cannot be moved with first core. He's too far back.
Oh, shifty shift.
Yeah, shifty pants.
Shifty and thrifty.
Whoa,
that's a heck of a shift.
I'm glad that happened since the coming of the attach command. What? That would have been game over.
Yeah. Soldiers everywhere. And bayonets. Alright, that it, Velker, for them?
Yeah, it's those three.
Those three, that's 9.
Keep going, Velker.
Oh, he keeps going.
Hooray! These guys.
Mm-hmm. Cossacks.
Bruh, the Cossacks! Wait. Let me measure this out, see if I can get to you.
I can't believe I haven't. Nope.
I figured not, but I thought I might as well try to finagle in a...
Try as you may.
Finagle.
I said finagle. Oh. All right, that's 12.
12.
You're done.
Yeah, I figured.
Do you have gunfire, Velker?
I do not.
No guns wish to shoot?
No.
You have no musketry that I can see, because those guys all moved. No melees. That's it. Now, let's just talk about this very briefly. This was turn 3. We're going now to turn 4. Velker, on turn 5, your next turn, this will be your first chance to try to bring on these reinforcements.
Cool.
Because their number, the number to get them on, is they're a 5 factor. Mm-hmm. So you have to roll the number you roll on the dice times 5 must be equal or less to than the turn number. And so you need to roll a 1, basically.
Oh.
1 times 5 is 5. And it's going to be that way till you get out to 10.
one.
No, it is a little tricky sometimes to get those reinforcements on the board.
Yeah, well, just ask Mike.
Luck, I'll get it first try.
Yeah, ask Mike about that.
Okay, what just about, ask what about him. This guy, though? Why are they in the trees?
Those guys over there?
None of your
beeswax. They're in the trees. They are concealed.
I see them though. That's the problem. They're not doing a great job.
Get your
job
hand on your side.
So get your hand on your own side of the battlefield. You don't.
I'm petting your horses.
I'm touching all yours. I'm touching.
Oh, he's touching all the fairies.
I'm touching the old guard.
Dalinore or Velker.
Hey, you can only touch Paco, and I don't see Paco here, so you can't touch anything. Except your own people, your own troops.
This is not a valid game. I need Paco.
No, you don't.
Yes, I do.
Velker, you have to roll mo dice.
Oh, I do? Oh, mm-hmm. Dang. Oh, darn.
I must check for them. Got it. Ron, you're up.
All right, we're starting the center again.
Here we go, kids.
Him, preparing him.
You guys are just going to stare at each other for about 12 turns, I'm guessing. Got it?
Now, next one over.
Sorry. Got it.
But he is activated so I could move him.
So many of him. Ah.
That's two.
Why are there so many of you? Explain this. What kind of recruitment have you been going through?
A good one.
Because I want. Well, we'll see. I want help with
we'll see if they start shooting.
Getting that many guys.
True. All right, that's two in the center.
I may have good trainers, but I apparently need better recruiters.
All right. The guard.
Mm-hmm.
Bearing him.
Yeah, game on, I guess.
That is not in range. I made sure of it.
Yeah, it is.
No, it's not.
Yeah, I'm touching the base.
No, you're not.
Yeah, he is.
No, he's not. I see pixels between.
No, that's a hit.
I made sure.
No, you didn't. Then you should have stayed further back than that.
How is this guy? Did they move? Because I'm sure that they weren't in range.
I'm telling you, both
I'm absolutely positive.
Those guys can shoot at each other.
There was like 0.4.
There will be no question. These guys can't.
Now these guys. Yeah, I was just gonna say these guys can't.
No, these guys can't.
I don't understand. I thought I made sure.
All right, so that's an individual move then, is the preparation.
So that's four for you. And I can't do core.
Oh, good, Velker.
Is he okay at four?
Yes.
Five, six. Is he okay? Velker?
Yes, six is good.
Yep.
I was thinking of Shaco. I didn't know you could do that.
Seven, eight. Is he okay?
Yes, eight is all well.
If you're gonna do that, you're gonna have to go back and prove to me that he can see him. Okay, very good. Continue. Just wanted to be sure.
No, I spun him too much. Okay, now I messed up how I had him.
No, it's all good. I mean, just go ahead and make the contact in a rough way, because look, this is our eternal issue. So, you got him. 9-10.
Yep, that's all right. 9-10. How about that, Velker?
Velker,
get some fighting going.
What is the number?
10.
He's good.
Keep going.
No, I'm good.
All set.
Yep.
Cannons. Any?
Oh, of course.
Very good. Another add. You're going to shoot, not reload. So that's 4, 5. 5 with a bonus.
I'll take that.
Two. I should have asked. Same guy or different guy? Okay.
It was a different guy.
Good. Got it.
That's all the cannons.
That's all the cannon. And now musketry. Got any?
Yeah. Over here on the right.
Oh, that's right. He didn't move. That's long range. That is, he's not there. So it's 3 with a bonus for the skirmishers.
Same ones.
3 of the bonus. Look at you lighting it up.
Yeah.
Doesn't happen much.
No, it don't. And I was afraid I was losing my die rolls due to the fact that I used them all in the last like 6 games that weren't Blucher. All right, these grenadiers.
I can never remember. Is there a negative to being in bad terrain? I don't think it matters either way.
Now, when he's halfway out, so it's like
shooter.
So I think it's 50%. As long as he's 50% out, I think it's.
Nope. Yeah. It's actually just as long as your nose is out.
Oh, yeah. I knew it's something like
that. Yeah, that's what got those Saxons killed. Remember that?
Well, right. Yep.
So, Grenadier up here. I'm assuming that's long range. Attached artillery is 9. 9 half. That's 5 with
five
the bonus.
Of the bonus.
5 with the bonus, yeah. That's rough.
All right, that's all. I got the horse here, so they can't fire, so that's it.
Yep. Melees. Which one you want first?
Yeah. All right, I start with the weaker one first.
All right, so that's a 5 because you have shock. This is an 8. Unfortunately, he does have to reroll all hits. So,
are they both the recon?
Yeah.
Didn't he roll 2 6s?
He did. He rolled 1 here and 1 over here.
Oh.
Those guys that you're not supposed to touch in the trees.
Oh.
So he's got 5. You've got 8.
All right.
Holy cow.
Six.
Yeah, so, and now you gotta reroll 6. Oh!
2!
Lost on the reroll. It's only a 1 loss, interestingly enough.
The forced to go back
six inches facing the wrong way. You just have to go. You just got to go back through your lines.
Is it the wrong way if I win? No, not you, Velker. Not you, the horse.
Oh, that's right. He's got to go back. That's right. He's got to bounce. What am I thinking? He's got to bounce. Right. No, you face. Yeah, you face towards. 6 inches facing towards. And now this one. This is, he is again an eight. And you are a six. 8-6. Four for Valkyrie. And you gotta reroll. Five to one. That's harsh.
It's French.
And yeah, in that instance, it is. Now you do have to turn around.
Wait, this guy's touching this guy.
It was all the fiddling with the angle stuff. You do have to bounce again, though. And I did forget to demerit you your 1 point. You always lose.
That was worth the cavalry charge.
That was a pretty good one.
Ivelka prepared the wrong ones.
Yeah, I think he might have been having his head in the Shaco game we had. There is much call for Paco out in the chat.
No Paco.
No, it's okay. I gotta get the Paco going.
I'm doing good.
Here.
No Paco.
All right, so the melees are done. That's it. All right, so now we go to turn five. Dalinore, if you give Velker some dice, please.
Velker, you may go.
Guard first.
All right. He appears to want to talk to you.
Apparently. We want to chat about.
A thing.
Bringing them in too, right? Come on in.
This guy's going to prepare. And so is this guy.
Okay.
Are you coming in at them or just staying right there, Velker?
Staying right there.
Staying right there, okay.
So by my count, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. And that gun is not close enough. Oh, actually, no, what am I saying? It passes through this guy, but he's not activated.
But if he can activate him, keep him there and to activate
he's not
that gun.
Move. He's just gonna shoot.
All right, that's fine. Then that's for free anyway. So anyway, that is, therefore, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. How's he doing, Ron?
You can go. He's doing good. Oh, that's right. You could charge over.
Yep.
Terrain doesn't matter, right?
Correct. He has to
eight.
That's eight.
Yes, you can still go.
All right.
And we continue?
You may continue.
You may continue. You will not take Elkerheim.
Oh. I'm ordering second core.
Okay.
This guy is going to scoot forward a little bit.
Alright.
And I get to order these guns, who are also going to scoot up a little bit. That then goes to these guns. Move up.
Nine, 10, 11. Anything for these guys? All right, so that would be 12, 13, unless he's close
enough. You are done.
12, you're done. Gunfire from Velker.
Move
dice. Whoa, what are you doing? You get gunfire.
I do? Oh, I thought it was simultaneous.
All right. No.
Both these guys should be able to shoot.
Right? No, they can't. Well...
They prepared.
Are they in range?
Yes. This guy is...
Yeah, but that's the one we just determined before. They were in range. But these guys, the ones to our right, and his left are...
Okay, he's got it. Go ahead, the guy who's in range. So this guy here? Yep.
This should be four.
3 plus 1, 4. It's half because it's skirmish range, so 2. Nothing there. How about these guns move? These guns move, but how about these guns? And there is a penalty for, is it all shooting? No, very good. It's just for musketry. So, that is still outside. So, these are what kind of guns? Heavy artillery, 6 with a bonus. That gun moved.
That's everyone.
Hey, okay, and now you got one melee?
I got more than that.
Where do you want to go first?
Start with this one.
Got 2.
2. All right. So, you've got shock, which takes you to 6. He's got 8.
9.
He's steady 9, but he's in difficult terrain, which takes him down to 8 again. So it is 8-6. 8-6.
Uh-oh. Oh, not good.
1, 2, 3, 4, 5 for Velker.
5-2?
Ouch.
Yep.
That's a loss of 3. Excuse. You guys are 8s?
Yeah.
Jeepers creepers.
Yeah.
That's what I was saying. My guys are scary, but...
Okay, so yeah, now they go back 6 inches facing the wrong way. Terrain doesn't matter. Velker, I got to pop you for 1 for the melee. You may take that ground if you wish.
I'm good.
All
right. Stick right here.
Nothing there.
Actually, if I move up, will I bump this guy?
No, you can't melee anyway.
No, why? I want to follow through.
I understand. Didn't work that way.
I want to stab him again.
I get that.
And he's in prepared formation, so I could smack him even harder. Right?
No, it's only the guns. That only affects artillery.
Oh.
All right. So we're over here now, right? These fellers?
On the left.
It is. You're in difficult terrain, so that's going to be a minus for you. So that's 3. And he is a 6. 3-6.
Oh, again.
Uh-oh. 2-2.
Oh, it's a tie.
It is a tie, which, of course, goes to the defender. So it's 1 loss here.
Didn't realize how bad you beat me up.
And that's 6 inches back, facing away. So, yeah, you lose 2 when you attack and lose. So you're going to have to go all the way back and pretty much... Well, you can also shoot that way, too, if you want. All right. And he's still attached to 1st Brigade here. Any other melees? Anything?
Nope, that's all I see.
I don't see any. All right, Velker, time for you to check. If you can roll a 1 on a 1d6, you will get your reinforcements.
A 2.
Alright, so they do not yet arrive. That is. So now we go to turn six, please. Velker, Ron, we'll need some mo dice.
Ready?
We're ready. Ooh,
Napoleon is joining them over here.
Napoleon shoots over to the right flank this time. Yeah, the guy who made those has invented just a ton of them. It kind of makes me want to bring on... He's got musketry, he's got sabers, he's got the whole bit. The guns are booming. Glad to hear it.
That's two.
You're good.
Hello.
Hello.
We're right here.
You're good. On the left side.
Oh, sorry. Left side. Thank you.
That about that 3-inch touching that corner.
I'm
no?
good. I'm good with that.
Okay.
What did we ever do before Lazy Boy invented penetratable trees?
You know?
Had them be flat?
Yeah, we did. We knocked the suckers. Yeah, we knocked them over, didn't we?
Well, I'm saying like it was a flat sheet instead of a...
Oh, yeah, yeah, yeah. We did knock them over, though.
Did we?
In the early sharp practice games.
I guess that was it for them, actually.
So you only activated...
Yeah, this guy.
That'd be four.
That's fine.
That's four, but you now you're stuck with independence.
Yeah.
So four, he can keep going, Velker?
What?
He can keep going with four?
Yes.
Roll on. I really do like Blucher. I've said that before.
Six.
How about six?
Six is good.
Roll it. Suddenly his dragoons don't want to fight anymore, Velker.
That's good. Maybe it's because they're all in square.
Yeah, they noticed the whole army go to square.
Eight.
Eight is good. Wait, is it? I don't remember. It is eight. It is eight. You must stop at eight. That's it. Never
You're
mind.
Done. You're finished.
Don't do anything.
All right. Cannon fire. Want to shoot that gun again?
Yeah, shoot this guy at the guys before.
Are you going to reload? Because that's something you can do, you know.
And I forgot to take
I,
down.
I will reload it.
I forgot to take one off. You're at your last four.
I thought it was 5, 4, 4.
Yeah, and you shot twice.
Oh, no, yeah. You're right, correct, yes.
So now this is a 5. 5 with a bonus. You've been wrecking with that thing.
Freaking cans are beautiful.
Well, I'm telling you, Zeke, in his battle with Mike, was ridiculous with his artillery fire. That was the one thing that really stands out.
Oh, yeah, I saw that. Yeah, it was. He was insane.
Musketry?
Yes. Right here on the... All right.
So what do we see? We see a current along of 6, 3 with a bonus. Nothing.
These guys, the same thing.
3 with... Is that how much with a bonus? It is halved, but it rounds up. So yeah, 3 with a bonus. Nothing. The muskets go silent.
Left side.
Who you're shooting at? Oh, you're saying there.
Yep.
That is volley range. Ergo, 7. Attached artillery does not help. Because I'm pretty sure that's...
I thought it was skirmishers.
Skirmishers are only at long range, and I think it's the same with attached artillery.
It just says plus one attached artillery when shooting. One shooting.
Very good. Very good. So we therefore say 8. Yep, 8, no bonus. One.
These grenadiers.
Who are they shooting
at?
Those grenadiers shoot 8, 9, am I right? What's the deal? What's the one thing you can't... That's right, is it just the skirmishers that don't help?
Just the skirmish, right.
When it's firing against enemy infantry... Yeah, there's... No, infantry penalties. You're firing at cavalry.
Oh.
So you're at half.
Oh, really? Okay.
Yep, you shoot at horses, you're at half.
Would it be 4 then plus 1, 5?
No, you get the attached first and then... Yeah, that's right. It's just math, Jim. It's not that complicated. 5 dice, no bonus.
What?
That's okay. We'll take them out like that.
Wow.
Ooh. Come on in, horsies. French are dead on shooting tonight. My sharpshooters.
Yeah, that was a goodie. Ouch. Is that it?
Oh, actually, I forgot about this one in the middle.
Oh, yeah. 3 with a bonus. Got it?
Yeah, for these guys are out over here.
Ooh, that's a toughie, though. You're pretty much in those woods. I mean, I don't know. That's a good question. That's a great question. I don't know the answer to that one. Just happened to turn to that area.
Oh, I know that it says in the rules that 50% of your line is not blocked. Shoot. Like if there's another infantry in your way, but 50% of your line can shoot, then it's not considered blocked.
Oh, I see what you're saying.
I would say this would be the same thing because it's over 50% that's not blocked.
I gotta find...
That's like 2 rows.
Gotta find terrain.
Where's Haz?
This is where Haz is supposed to be here. We're all very upset because, and we're playing Blucher for God's sake. This is the one thing that he really likes. There's the thing. There's the picture. Shoot. Yeah, that makes reasonable sense. What you're saying, 45 degree fire arc, prepared infantry, yeah. Shooter must have.
Yeah, because if you look at example, they're saying that this artillery can't shoot between two artillery because it's
where's
less
that?
Than
where?
Half.
What page is that?
49. Two between units. It's almost considered the same thing.
Yeah. Oh, there it is. That's it. Shooting between terrain. The gap is less than half a base width. So the point is you've got to have an inch and a half.
It's because, like, if you look at it, like,
and this is why this is where I'm being punished for not having a base out. But yeah, that's a shot. That's fine.
I just want to make sure. I mean, I'm just, you know.
No, I agree. I mean, it's a tough one because I don't have a base. But given the fact that it really seems to draw a line right about here, you've got a chunk of your base out. So that's 3 inches.
Three of the bonus?
Three of the bonus.
Guess it was mute anyway.
Yeah, we went through a whole lot of trouble for nothing.
But well, at least we know next time. I mean, we'll try to get bases next time.
Right. Is that all she wrote?
Oh, that's all she wrote.
All right, the game is definitely afoot. So that takes us to turn 7.
How you doing, Velker?
Not great.
It's a bit of a struggle over there.
Less filling. All right, you're up.
All right, second core.
All right.
Make it.
Yes, you can. What? You ignore that terrain when you charge.
That's right.
Except horses don't.
Thanks for telling me that. I can't remember any of this stuff.
Yeah, horses. Yeah, the horses are the one exception with the.
Yeah. Makes sense. They can't go running through trees.
I know
right.
Why it makes sense.
They can go over the stream, but they can't go through the trees.
Right. And they can't go through urban areas.
Oh, you're right. Urban areas, they can't. I found that out the hard way.
That works.
Yeah, but it's just.
You're kidding
close.
Me!
That is fully almost a half inch. As you were.
The French. They're just laughing at you.
They're left. Well, no, they didn't come. They are taunting them. They are taunting the Cossacks at a distance.
Yeah, taunting. Come on. You're not gonna get to me.
So that
we'll just sit here and drink our wine.
Yeah, there you go. So let's be clear. That activation was 1, 2, 3.
Yes.
So how's he doing? I'm assuming he can keep going.
Yes, he's doing well.
All right, Velker, you're up.
Get this guy.
No, I didn't. Oh, hey.
Forget about me.
He's hitting that urban area. So he's got to stop.
Four and a half. How much further can he move?
That's about it. No,
you have to stop when you hit the urban area.
You got to stop when you hit the town.
Stop
yeah. Because you'll have spent more than half. You can only move half when you move.
Oh, I thought it just halves when you hit it.
No. And the same thing over here, bud.
What? No,
if you hit the crop field, you have to stop. You have to. You can only. It halves you to six.
Oh, it. I thought it was in just blocks line of sight.
No,
the opposite.
It doesn't block line of sight.
I know.
Yeah. All right, so that was 3
What have you been doing?
Just for the record, I gotta check something. So that was three.
Wait a minute.
Yeah, they're not even the same core. We gotta be careful here.
Yeah, they're not the same core.
And this guy, you moved. Are you activating anybody else in that core?
Oh, yeah. Oh, this guy's gonna back up.
Okay, that's fine.
Why are you backing up?
Because I don't like you. Play. And you smell bad.
Don't play.
And how about this guy?
Ooh.
Are you doing anything with him?
No.
Okay, so that's 3, 4, 5. Can he continue?
He's still good.
All right, so then that's 6, 7. Can he continue?
Still good.
All right, so you're done and you're good.
Can I move and take off my prepared markers at the same time?
It's automatic when you move.
Is that touching?
Ooh, saucy.
Yes. Yeah, that's going to be a hit.
I come at you.
Yeah, if I could shoot you, you can hit me.
Right. Same problem there is that this guy...
He's at 3! And he's a part of the guard!
You sure you want
to
do that?
Remember, I smacked him.
Do you remember? He's been pounding on you. Do you want to take that back?
Yes.
All right.
No. Go back.
Six inches?
He wants to talk.
He was there. No, he was in shooting range. That's the key point. We know this is shooting range. So that's 7. You got anything else? You have not done anything over here yet.
Yeah, I know.
Guns.
Okay.
He fits perfectly. Or not, but whatever, it works. He's levitating, but it's fine.
No, let's sort it out just a little bit and we can...
It's alright. It's not gonna...
No, you're not supposed to be on top of each other. And he's no longer prepared. So that was 7, 8, 9 with the guard. Nothing else is guard unless you want to move these guys.
I want to move into shooting range, but then again, I don't want to move into shooting range.
That's the great problem.
He's going to stay where he is.
All right, that takes him to 9. Ron, how's he doing?
He's good.
As well. Let's pickle this guy. Nero.
Hey, Val, did you see these horses? They're also... There are 4.
Well, I know they're there. And they're a hurdy, right? Mm-hmm. Yeah.
How come you can't shoot in any angle in a repaired state?
Goodbye.
Hey, where you going?
Away.
Show me the horse's butt, huh?
Yeah, what if I am?
Yeah, maybe he is. Yeah. Well, no, you gotta turn first.
Oh, are you?
Yep.
Take my flank, I don't need it anymore. Okay, I do need... Those are the bad guys, no!
You sure you want to do that?
Otherwise I'm going to be blasted, so yes.
Okay. That's 11. 12, I'm sorry. That was 12. How's he now?
He's done.
All right. Artillery fire?
Right. In actuality, that's actually a good move, because I can't do a charge because there's trees in our way.
Correct. You can't see him.
You can't see my rear end?
Nope.
This guy can shoot.
Well, first of all, you've got the gun thing. You've got cannons. That guy can't shoot. He moved.
Yeah, he moved.
These two did not. So you want to shoot?
Who could they shoot at?
I don't
this
know.
This guy?
Yes.
Yep, you can see his front center.
You can see this. Yes, you can.
He'll do that.
He can also see
he's
and
not
shoot.
Not gonna go for the horses. They're too far away.
He can shoot them, just so you know. But that is.
It's the same thing as shooting. It's the same thing as shooting these guys.
Is it?
Same number of dice, Velker. Yeah.
That's a good question. Now that I'm thinking about.
Oh, because of the cannons. Yeah, right.
No, that's infantry penalty. It doesn't affect horses. It doesn't affect guns. It only affects infantry. So it would be
right,
the same.
So then it's the same.
It would
thing.
Be the same
yeah.
number of dice either way.
Then I'm gonna go with these guys.
Would have thought you might. Six dice. That's a heavy. So seven dice, no bonus. Or sorry, six
yeah,
dice.
About to lose
dice.
The first one.
Six
it's
dice.
And a bonus.
Yeah, six with a bonus, not seven, sir.
Come on!
Ouch.
That's good. That's it. Stop. That's a good roll. That's a hit. A palpable hit.
Brings you down to one.
Yeah. Almost kills him. Okay. And this guy can shoot.
But he won't.
Okay, very good. No other gunfire that I see. Musketry.
Here.
You got some somewhere? Very good. Yeah. What's your current? 3, 4, 2, I'm assuming. How did you fall so far out of range? You need to be closer.
You're not going right on top of me. That's the problem.
Is that it?
Straight above.
Am I failing? Oh, that is better. But you're still a little far back. There we go. Alright, so yeah, three dice. 3 dice, no bonus.
Yeah, 3 dice, no bonus.
No hit.
Wow. Bonus, or is it...
Oh no, it would have been two. It would have been two. Doesn't matter. Yeah, I'm sorry, it would have been two, because your attached artillery takes you to four, half to two. Alright, no hits. They're out of range. Any other gunfire?
No.
Alright, you got melees.
Alright,
this is an interesting one. We're going to say both of you are out of the weeds, so that's going to work for you. You have shock, which takes you to four. Four.
He's a nine.
4 to 9. Three. Whoa. That was much closer than it should have been.
Yeah,
it's two difference.
It doesn't matter, as long as you lose, you lose. Yep.
What game am I thinking of?
It is the difference if you win, but when you lose, it's just when you lose, the winner. He loses 1 point for just being in the fight.
Yes.
You lose two for losing.
That's what I'm saying.
Yeah.
The difference was two, so that means.
Yeah.
I take...
No, but that's not why. You always lose two, even if you had lost by 10.
Really?
Yep. Mm-hmm. So now you turn around and run away 6 inches.
I'm running this way.
Nope. This one.
Well, it's actually any clear way. He could go anywhere. Anyway.
I'm not. Well, he's supposed to. Remember, he's supposed to move through his
flank. Six.
6 inches. He's supposed to move through his flank lines directly away.
Well, directly away would be in this direction.
Well, let's put you here. We know you were there, right?
I mean, yeah, you can go this way. You
and
can
so
go this way.
Your flank line is here, and it's directly away. Yeah, I guess you're right. No, I stand corrected. But I don't know how you're going to get 6 inches back. Can you?
I get further away because I run on top of these guys.
That's true. So turn around, go 6 inches, and show me. Yep. No, that's right. Well, no, you gotta get closer, you know. You don't have to go that far. You can come
but
back
I want
here.
To go that far.
No, that's I'm not letting you do that. You're here. That's the garbage I was trying to avoid.
Right.
You know, because you can't move laterally through your whole line just to get away. No.
This place that should just displace them all.
Mm-hmm.
The prepared should stop.
All right, and here we are over here at this melee.
Oh, I forgot about. Oh, wait a minute. We got the center one too, Jim. Let's do the center.
Which one you want to do, Velker?
Got two in the center.
Ooh, mercy. Which one? That one. Straight up. That's one of the first. Okay, attached. No. So five. Six. 5 to 6. One to a bunch. Oops, sorry. You got to take 2 hits. I apologize. And you got to take 1. All right. Now this one.
We're both in the trees.
Yep. You're both going to take that naughty penalty. So 5.
6 to 6. 5 to 5.
5 to 5. Another defeat. This is a brisk one. This is brisk. Six inches facing the wrong way. Nope, facing the right way. Dang it! When will I ever remember that? Attackers face the right way. Defenders go the wrong way when they lose.
Oh, that's right.
Doggone it. Anyway. And this one? So that's 4.
4 to 5.
Three apiece.
It's a tie.
Yeah, tie goes to the defenders, we know. Takes you to 4. Takes you to 3. 6 inches the wrong way. You've attached him, however, to this guy.
No,
yep. Mm-hmm. He was attached to that guy and was never moved. And now he's at risk. So you need 1d6.
That's not the one he's defending, right?
Nope. It's whenever he's attached to that unit, when he gets an adverse result, you have to roll the die. So it's 1d6 on a 6, he's out.
Ooh, close.
Velkerheim was so close, but it was not there. All right. Anything else? All right. It is now time to roll Velker again for your reinforcements. Again, on a 1d6, you need a 1. Not here yet. It is now turn 8. Can Dalinore have some dice, please? Sounds like he has them. Ryan, you're up.
All right, we're going on the right flank first.
So you're putting Napoleon there? That's where he's doing his magic?
Yep.
Okay.
Yes, sir. I checked the measurement. This guy is in core range.
Okay.
Oh, the marker. I'm like, I'm not on the horses.
There you go.
Okay. Ah, Velker, all you guys left. They want to play?
Now they're talking rescue animals in the chat. Not that there's anything wrong with that. try to get some more good pictures. Suddenly, he doesn't want to be in the river.
Now, I don't want them going too far away to freaking chain command. All right, so we got 1, 2, 3, 4.
What's two?
Oh, two. Duh. Two. Duh.
Because you got the magic man over there. Where'd you go?
I'm sorry, center. Just looking. I'm trying to see who I want
to
go with.
Just trying to show the home audience what trouble you're up to.
Me? Trouble? All right, we'll go with movie center, guys.
No, the thing we're trying to get trending is hashtag Marshall Blucher with M and B capitalized.
I have swamps on my die roller.
You do?
I do.
Is that an omen?
Is that why I've been rolling so badly?
Could be.
Am I in Shrek's swamp? Does he need me to get out?
Oh dear. Ooh, short. Well, they shot at each other. Well, they so shot at be. Each
other. He charged me before, so.
Yep, fair enough. Yep. There's a lot of charge.
This will counter charge.
A lot of charger fighting going on.
Seven.
How's he doing at seven?
How's that, Velker?
He's good.
Continue, please.
All right, I'm going individual.
All right.
Rallying.
4, 5, 6.
No, he decides not to rally.
No, it's three. I'm sorry, it's 3, 4, 5, 6. It's 3, 4, 5, 6. So you're good. That's 9, Velker.
He may continue.
Continue, please.
Rally.
Mm-hmm. What number did I just give you?
3, 4, 5, 6.
No. For your mo dice. Was it 9 or 11?
9.
So now it's 11?
Yes.
How can he go?
He's done.
You're done. With that rally, which I give you, there it is. You are finished with your activation, sir.
I completely forgot about rallying.
Well, you can do it now. You can start doing it now. I was wondering why you weren't, to be honest.
I have so many rules.
You know, I may be crippling my son here because I make him learn so many rules.
Yeah, right. Well, also, too, he's got to be at least 12 inches away from any...
Well, true, but really he good. Hasn't been making any effort to get that far away either.
That's true, too.
So, gunfire?
Reloading.
Let's be fair. Velker only knows attack.
That's true, too.
Oh, Mike is still here.
Oh, yeah. That's why I've been very careful not to say anything impolite about him.
Why stop now?
Why start good manners now, right? All right, so...
That's right.
So you've
everybody
got...
Everybody on the right moved.
So that gun is... I gave you a reload. They all moved. You got any other shots? You got shots?
Yes, over here with the guard.
I think just this one, right? Because everybody else is out. So this is... Woo, they're still good. That's four. Yeah, that's four dice. With a bonus.
Oh!
What?
Wow. That's a wipeout.
That's the second time you rolled that. Three sixes in one shot.
Is that a remarkable shot? Much credit.
They're the guards. What do you expect?
Yeah, there you go. They're shouting Vive l'Empereur and biting their shot.
Vive l'Empereur!
All right, that drops Velker's morale to 7. All right, next. I don't think there's anything else for shooting.
That's all the musket shots.
Miles, which one you want?
Over here.
Let's see. That's 5. And he's steady. So, yeah, 5-5. Whoa! I don't know how steady they are when they're flipped over, but okay.
Oh, all right, got this one.
You are rebuked, sir. So give me a second. That bounces you down to 3. Got him. And this bounces him down to 1. And, or to 2, 3 also. And you have to go back, say, Sanchez, facing the same way, please. Yeah, that Russian steady thing is nasty. At least prospectively. Here we are. So we see Velker with 4. And you with 5. 4-5. Whoa. Velker, where you been sitting on that?
3-3.
That's another win for Velker.
Wow, I guess...
Apparently attacking was not the thing to do.
Yes, not the thing to do. Shooting is the thing for my guys.
The Tsar is watching.
I believe that's it.
Yeah. All right. Next turn is turn 9. Turn 9. Ron, you need some more dice.
Elker, you may go.
Don't. That's an individual action.
That's true. Just looking at it.
Okay. Just trying to keep up with you.
How far do you have to be to rally? 6.
You have to be 6 inches away.
6.
Correct.
Okay. I thought it was 12, but it might be 6.
If it's 12, I am done for.
Not necessarily. You can move. Six inches.
All right, so first core. Well, let's start with these guys, I guess.
Mm-hmm. It's 3 no matter what. So back, you gotta back up.
Bringing up the reserve.
And they can't rally when they move, right?
Correct.
That's four.
We'll chase you back all the way back to Petersburg.
Four. Can you keep going?
Yes, you can.
You're up. You can't. That's the point. You can't do that. You cannot get around that town that way. You're going to have to position yourself. You're going to have to turn enough to get past that town without hitting it. If you're looking to charge, you cannot charge through a town. So if you turn yourself all the way to 45 degrees, if you do it 90, you do it easy. You just do it in two turns. But if you turn yourself to 45 right there, You can go shooting out a good distance. The problem is you're not going to... Show me a true 45. Go back to where you were. Tilt one more time to your left.
I'm in the town.
No, I understand, but you'd be allowed to turn in... Yeah, you can hit that guy, is my point, if that's what you're looking to do.
That was what I was trying to do.
The only question...
Oh, miss, his center is not...
Oh, right. That's right. Your center isn't to his center. Can he get there?
Nope. Well, yeah, your center does not. Yeah, your center does not pass through any part of my. Even if it nicked it, but it doesn't.
No, but I'm saying is, not the way he charged. But if he comes like this, which he could do, he's going to bonk there, and then he can't see the center of that guy.
Right.
Yeah, it's a two. It's going to be a two move thing.
And his corner clips this anyway, doing that.
Well, I'm not going to worry too much about that piece because
right.
He could probably turn around it if it weren't for the way TTS works.
True.
But either way, he can't. You can't melee these guys in a one turn deal. So what do you wish to do?
Oh, the sand disappeared. Where'd it go?
Okay, I'm going to move on to solo actions.
All right.
Stop this guy.
All right. You can only turn 45 degrees. Cannot
charge. And he because you couldn't even see him anyway, because you're facing.
You're facing this way, but.
I know.
45 degrees only.
You have to. Yeah. Or a charge. Now you can move anywhere you want, but you can't charge. That's the problem.
Yeah. So that's legit. What you've done is legit. You can certainly face that way. Very good. So this is 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Can you keep going?
Yes, you can.
Next. I would pass along Velker that this guy is well out of range.
It's about to start figuring out who to rally.
Those guys are done.
Yeah, start with this guy.
Okay. That takes him to 8. How's he doing?
He's good.
Next. He is inside 6 inches.
Is he?
Yep. You guys have been shooting at each other? Yep, that's fine.
Actually, we haven't been. Oh, man, these two haven't been shooting at each other. Just out of 6 inches.
Oh, they're both that way?
Yeah, 6.2. Oh, okay. Yeah, we haven't.
So do you want to rally him, Velker?
Yes.
That's fine. You rolled it fair.
You can't.
He's only down to 6. Yeah, he's got so you can count it on this guy, and he's got nothing. So he's still at full strength. I missed that.
He is. All my weakened guys move.
And I don't know what your intentions are, but I do observe that you have.
He's defending that.
Okay, got it. So you're still at 8. You haven't activated anybody since. You're done?
Mm-hmm.
including the guns? Yes. Okay. Any artillery fire?
What do you mean guns? Yeah, they're not going to move.
All right. So, do any of those guys I just pinged want to shoot? Can't see them.
You could earlier.
Nope, not. You couldn't see that.
I moved them into.
He moved them into the trees, so you couldn't. You still see those horses?
I'm not going to shoot at the horses.
All right.
Oh, that's right. I did shoot at the horses last time.
Yeah, you did.
Same amount. I forgot about that. Yeah.
Shoot at the horses.
Wait, did they rally?
Yep.
All right. I'm going to shoot at the horses.
Okay.
What did the horses do to you?
They killed half of a unit.
Six dice.
But not to the. They didn't do anything to the cannons.
Six dice, no bonus.
Six dice? Really?
Yep. Wow. They're heavy artillery.
Heavy artillery gives a bonus.
Holy cow.
Well, it doesn't matter anyway, but heavy artillery gives a bonus, not extra die.
Okay. Still.
It doesn't matter. He rolled so high.
Holy cow. Yeah. That's a wipeout. One morale down. I have marked down the, marked down your thing. So, okay.
How did he get so low?
How did that dragoon get so low?
Yeah.
He came in and meleeed you. And remember, he was fatigued because he was on the recon.
But
he started out at 4.
All right. I did 2, did I? Oh, did he fight twice?
I don't know if he fought twice, but he was down to 1. Yeah. So.
Well, I shot him down to 1.
Yeah, I got hurt smacking you over here, Velker.
Yeah.
I remember that.
All right. Yeah, remember he came charging into you guys who were unprepared?
Yeah, but.
And that still, he still takes damage from that.
Did he do that twice though?
No, but it's I you'd have to go back through. Anyway, he's gone. So, do you want to shoot these guns?
No, that's all the guns.
All right. Any musketry? Those guys all moved.
These guys.
Yeah, those guys have been shooting at each other and mealing each other. 2, 3, 2. 2, no bonus.
It's, yeah. You still get a 2 even though it's half?
Yeah, because its current Alon is 2, plus 1 is 3, half is 1.5, which rounds up to 2.
Okay.
There's a hit. Ooh. Ping.
There.
Yep.
So, 2.
Aren't I in the woods?
Nope.
You got your tip out.
That edge is out.
Okay.
Yeah, that edge is out. My goodness. I would let you shoot out anyway, because you can't shoot out either. But it's 3, 4, 2. Nothing there. That was all the musketry, I think. They're all done.
Yep.
They're all done. Another chance at your reinforcements. 1 die.
Hey, has just showed up.
All right.
Now that we don't need him anymore.
Don't talk about all the things we screwed up, because God knows we probably did. That's turn 10. It is now, we're heading to midday. Velker, some more dice for Ron, please.
Who is winning? He's asking. I didn't.
Right now, the advantage certainly sits with Ron, although I will say this. Here's the interesting point. Ron's got a big lift because he's behind 7-2 on the strategic map. And right now, he's only switched one of the singles. This is a 1, so it's now... It's now 6 to, math is hard, 6-3. 6-3, because Velker is still very much holding on to Karlzek.
All right, I have, I'm sorry, do we have mo dice?
Yes, you do, right? Velker, did you give him mo dice?
I did.
You're good.
Is he eligible for garrison here, or no?
Yeah, absolutely.
I like to garrison him. I like to garrison for 5. Would you?
You are garrisoned. Hey, it's Ian Jackson. I didn't notice you come in. Velkerheim has claimed Velker smiles at you. Okay, look, stop. My wife is asking me, how does anyone ever miss Ian Jackson? They swing too high? I'm kidding.
That is two.
You, of course, may keep going.
I'm switching over to individual.
All right.
I'm over here on the left.
I see you.
That would be four.
Mm-hmm. Can you keep going?
Yes.
Six.
Continue.
Gonna rally these guys.
They're 6 inches away from everybody? Okay. Go for it.
That's a heck of a rally.
Big rally.
Only one, but.
Does he get two spirits back?
Right, no kidding. It's 10, correct?
Correct.
You're done.
And you're done.
Fine, do that way.
Gunfire. Got any?
Cannons.
They're going to shoot. Got to knock you down again to a three, but you're right. Now you get to be a four for just one more minute. But you got dude with them, right? Yep. So that's five. Five. And where are you going here? Five with the bonus.
Five with the bonus.
Ooh, he's going for the kill.
Sure is.
Oh, I only get one.
Insufficient. But they are now fatigued.
Yeah, but you know what? They've been hitting good, so.
Yeah, hard to complain. Musketry?
All right. Still here on the right.
Okay. So that's halved anyway. So skirmisher three with a bonus.
I'll take it.
Okay.
I was just checking.
Okay. Fair enough.
All right, these guys here, I think it's just one.
Did they not just rally?
No, these guys
rallied. Oh, those guys rallied, sorry. Yeah. So yeah, that's one with a bonus.
And I roll a one.
One.
Misfire.
Misfire.
All right, these guys, I guess, will shoot out.
Seven. Four with a bonus.
I don't have any more shots.
I don't think you do.
Nope.
And no melees, right?
And yeah, no melees this time.
All right. Been a lot of good fights, but none that time. Turn 11. Give Velker some mo dice. Looks like they're in place.
All right. And we're good.
Velker, you're ready to go.
I am. Start with some rallies.
Do some rally work. All right. Yep. It's 3-6.
Oh.
Got it. Nobody there.
Oh, the one that you needed.
So that's 6. Can you keep going?
Yes.
Checking. Eight. Can you keep going?
Yes.
Everything.
Okay. Call it there.
I know that's not everything. I need this guy.
Okay. What do I do? I
forgot about him. I can't see this guy, right?
Sure you can. That's good. This is an angle thing. This is you can hit him if I'm almost certain that. Just show me the range. Keep going. Yep, you got him. It's fine. All right. Shoot, that's 12. How is he now?
That's 12.
Done.
Or 10. Sorry, that was 10. That was 10. He's done.
Yeah, he's done.
Okay, done at 10. Sorry about that. All right, cannon. Do you want to fire your guns? Very good. What's he got? That's a heavy gun. That's a 6 with a bonus.
Oh!
The guns wake up. Any other guns?
I think that's everyone.
All right. Musketry?
Is this guy in range? No.
Nothing there. Nothing here.
They're right here.
Yep, that's been the... That's the slapping fight.
2 dice.
Nope.
This guy.
2 dice. Wait, sorry. Yeah, 2 dice. Okay.
Melee.
Let's have a melee fight.
I've got 8.
I got five.
Yep. Holy cow. Seven to four? Is that what I'm seeing?
Yeah.
So three. Doesn't kill him.
Well, it couldn't kill him, right?
You could have. Oh, yeah.
What?
He only had five.
I thought...
It's when you're attacking, the difference counts.
When you're attacking, but not when you're defending.
Right.
Okay, that... Okay, that makes more sense. Oh, you were making me... Okay.
And you go... Yep, you're doing the right thing.
Human traits?
Yeah, because you attacked him... He now has to turn around and go the other way.
Even though I'm cavalry?
Correct. That only counts against infantry. Okay. Infantry bounces you.
Okay.
You may also advance into that space if you wish.
I think I will.
3 inches. And suddenly there's a unit of cuirassiers running around in the French backfield.
Yeah, not like that.
Can't imagine Ron's feeling that. All right, you want to? Let's see here. We are on turn 11. Ooh, so your odds have improved. Now, if you roll a 1 or a 2, your reinforcements will arrive.
Hooray! Oh, so close!
It was. Really? It was definitely rolling that way. I saw it. I saw it, but not yet. It's now high noon. Modi for Ron.
Oh, is it rolled?
You got him, Velker?
Oh, I do not have the modi, so I apologize. All right, got him.
All right, going on the right flank again.
Putting down old Bonet. Doing my photojournalist bit.
All right, 2.
Roll on, Big River. It is very funny that these battles often start off as, let's go get 'em! And both sides come hard, and then all of a sudden, when they're down to guys that have Alans 1, 2, and 3, both sides start going, you know, maybe these trees aren't so bad after all.
Minds.
Maybe these trees aren't so all right, bad after
go,
all.
Go on left flank.
All right. Ooh.
Aggressive.
Super serial.
I don't like how you're approaching me there, bud.
Ooh, he's not touching you.
He's not touching me.
I am not touching you.
Are you not touching me? You will regret this. I touch you. I touch you very hard. With pointy stick.
With pointed stick. Obviously, that's gone. Oh, and out comes Jean Lan. And to be clear, Lon is attached to the these fellows there. Okay, just checking. Is that 6, Velker? How is he?
6, Velker.
You may continue.
Continue, please.
Now we're going individual.
Very good. Where are you going? Velker is confused. So that was 2, 6, 8.
8.
Velker?
8 is good.
Continue.
Rally.
Go. No.
Oh, it doesn't.
10 is good.
10, continue.
Coming out prepared. They bold move on your part.
Yes, I knew. 12.
12?
That's it.
You're done, sir. You are done.
I'd be that way.
I think you will. Cannon?
Is the cannon going to reload?
Nope, I'm shooting.
Alright, so let me first... Wow. Holy cow.
That gun is
four dice
firing rapid
with
fire.
Four dice with a bonus. Well, honestly, this is the thing that Zeke got into, because he was pounding away so hard he almost exhausted the gun for no bonus or for one.
Yes!
Oh, the gun finally fires blanks. Look at that. Mm.
Ran out of gunpowder midway through, huh?
I guess. Musketry.
Stop.
3 with a bonus.
Stop.
No, sorry. Oh. Can't shoot. Bring them back to full strength.
Oh, I take this back. It's 3 no bonus because skirmishers don't count.
No. Jim.
Yes.
Jim. Put those horses back to full strength.
Why is that?
I'm in the river. I can't shoot in the river.
Oh my goodness. Spoken like a gentleman. Unfortunately, Velker, he is going to be rewarded for his honesty later in this game. But they are returned to full strength.
No, he was weak. He was one of the recons, I'm pretty sure. And he's a hooser.
Yeah, he's still a 6. Hoosers are 6.
No, but
yeah, but at a minimum, though.
No, his name.
Oh, I gotta change his name.
Yeah.
But at a minimum, Velker's right. He's gotta be, yeah, because Velker didn't get any 6s, but he's gotta be a 5.
Right, but I meant to, yeah, what I meant was bring up from that one hit I got
yeah.
on him.
Yeah, so he'd be a 4 then. Okay. Much better.
Oh, yeah. Alright, so no shooty over here on the right.
No shooting.
Cannons. Alright, these guys are gonna throw pellets at each other again.
Now, at this point, they're just throwing their guns at each other. One that is 1 with a bonus.
Picking up rocks and just throwing them.
It's happening. It's no thing. He can't go, but he can. That is 4-2 with a bonus. Ooh, fatigues him.
My toes, no. Oh, that's not good. He's at a 1. My hands is.
Any other musketry? I don't think so, right?
Nope. Just staring over here at each other.
Yeah, they're in fierceness, right? They're in the range of great fierceness. All right, well, here's what we're going to do. Given the hour, we're going to say this is the last turn for tonight. So we're going to say it is now, and by turn, I mean the whole sequence. So 13 and 14, because Velker was first. So
okay.
For turn 13, because that'll take us actually to the second half of the day, which is a nice place to stop anyway. So, Ron, if you would give Velker the last round of Russian Mo Dice for the evening.
Go ahead, Velker.
Poker face, Ron. Poker face.
Where is that poker face?
I know, right?
Doesn't sound like there is one. All right. I'm prepared.
Facing you right here. Here's my poker face right here.
What are you doing here?
That guy's moving up.
You're bonking him? Okay.
Well, you can bonk, but the problem is his center is still.
Yeah, you can't melee him. You can't remember?
Can I turn then?
Nope. Mm-mm. The only guy that can melee him is this guy.
I want to bump him.
The only guy that can bump him is that guy, and he's going to get himself two fights.
He's not going to move.
All right, then he can shoot.
He's not going to move.
Both, you know, to be clear, both guys can shoot.
All right, that's good. I'll keep it that way then. He's Cossacks, though.
Oh, I'm sorry. Whoa, coming over here. So, just so we're clear, that's an individual move at that point, unless you're moving these guys.
Yeah, I'm going to move these guys, too.
All right, so the second core, go. All right, pal.
Yeah, I knew that was coming.
Mm-hmm. I mean, I figured you had to, right?
So what's this guy doing?
He's gonna turn.
Where are you going? No, come back. We're not done throwing rocks.
Our rock fight. We were having an honorable rock fight. We're having an honorable rock fight.
No, snowballs. Because this is Russia.
Well, I was gonna say it's a Bavarian ground. We'd have snowballs.
But I'm Russian, so I throw a snowball. We're out of snowballs. This guy too. Wait, what's his alarm again?
He's at a 1.
Yeah, he's gonna hop on out of there. See y'all later. Bye.
Like, whoa, wait, it's like when he's suddenly highly motivated.
Suddenly turns into the Flash.
So that's 1, 2, 3. Since we know you got at least 3, I'm pretty sure you can keep going.
I should hope so.
Yeah. What's next?
That's what I'm looking at. All right, now these. Oh gosh, did you enter my range?
Yep.
Of course I did.
You entered my no-no square. No.
I know, no square.
My no square. No.
Just remember, you move this guy, so unless you move somebody else.
Yeah, that's a single.
Okay, you've gone to singles now?
Yes, I've gone to singles.
All right, so we did 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Can we keep going?
Yes.
Keep going.
Why are you leaving? I want to hug you. I give great hugs, I tell.
As says, Velker used 6 mo on 3 individual actions.
Hello. I can't get within your range, so I'm going
to... No, these were... These here... This is all 2-core.
They were in range at first.
They were in range when they started.
Cossack was back here.
Yeah, they were fine, so that's 1, 2, 3. And then this 5. One here was 4, 5.
Now this one is 6, 7.
6, 7. Yeah. We good?
Seven's
yes.
Good.
He's good to keep going? Yeah, yeah.
Okay. Yep, Haz says, oops. Same core, he didn't realize that.
Okay, Haz, we forgive you. You're usually right most of the time.
Yeah, I was going to say, considering you've been at this for over a year and your batting average is pretty high, my friend.
Finally.
Ha ha! Gotcha.
Of course, Velker's mother is yelling at him. Velker's mother's yelling at him in the chat too. So.
Oh good.
That's never happened to me. I'm telling you.
So. No, she's yelling at you, Velker.
Wait, what? Hold on.
It's only 9 o'clock, and you try to sleep.
9 o'clock sleeping. That doesn't exist. Only little kids do that, and I'm not a little kid.
Oh boy, here we go.
I'm a big kid now.
My daughter's been in bed for over a couple of hours now.
Whoa. Wait, how old is your daughter?
Of course, she has to. She's 20. She has to be to work at 4:30 in the morning. So
oh, there you go.
Kind of forgive her that.
Yeah.
Whoa.
There you go. Yeah.
Well, I'm usually in bed by 9 myself. It's like 10 o'clock here.
We're getting there.
All right, I know, so I had more actions. I just can't find them.
You did, well, you're, yeah, your cost, he pushed you, he pushed into your rally ring.
Scoot over here.
Yeah, that would be fine. I'm going to give you that. Well, yeah, that's fine.
Scoot. Can I scoot over here?
3 inches, yeah.
Well, I'm the horse, I don't think a 6. Or is it just...
No, because you're, remember, you didn't start even. You had to move like that. Yes. You had to angle.
Right. Very well. So that's now 9.
9. How's he doing, Ren?
He's doing good.
Yep.
Get out of my town.
He's like,
get out of my swamp.
New.
I will not leave. I will not leave Kaltenbach.
No.
We talked about this.
I'm not going to attack him.
All right.
I'm just getting through.
That's fair.
I'm going to point at you. I'm pointing at you. Doing lots of pointing.
Well, Fancy Hunts is going to shoot at you, but okay.
Oh, no. I don't want to be shot at. I didn't think of that. The sarcasm. All
right. So, 9. How's he doing?
He's doing good.
That would be 11.
Yeah, it is 11.
Oh, 11, yeah. How's he doing at 11?
He's great.
Ooh. This guy's going to pull a 180 and look at those guys. I turn my eyes upon you.
13.
That's everything.
Still good.
So you're good? What was his number, Ron?
16.
Yeah. Too short of the best.
Yeah.
All right, Cannon, gonna shoot any of them?
I like these guns. I like those guns a lot, in fact.
All right.
They did well last time.
All right, they're
5 with bonus. Right.
Correct.
Yep, 5 with the bonus. Ow!
2 hits. Oh,
he is
spooked.
He is spooked.
Now he is spooked. You're right.
He's very spooked.
Anything, any other gunnery?
I don't think so.
No, this guy, no. Hey, Velker?
I don't want to.
Okay.
Wait, he's at 1. Yes, I do.
I'm just saying.
I can pay attention, I swear. I'm good in school.
Just saying.
5 with a bonus.
That is correct.
Got him.
With the bonus, that's a kill.
Good, Ron, shot, Walker.
Good shot. Yeah, your morale drops too.
7.
Yep.
7 to 7.
Mm-mm-mm. I brought it back.
All right. So now musketry.
Yep. All right. Get right here.
Who do you want to go first?
Start with this guy on that guy.
All bets are off. The attached artillery works no matter what, so that's 7 dice. No bonus.
2 hits. Skeet shoot.
First nick on him.
Yes, I have injured your great grenadiers.
Yeah, they're no joke. How about your guy shooting over at him? That's
same thing.
7, 8. No, this is 8, no bonus.
Wow, yeah.
Oh, gee. Well, no, you only got 1.
Had I been a melee, you should
yes,
say.
Yes. Had that been a melee. Alright, so that's that. Other shooting. I don't see any. That guy moved.
Yeah, I think that's everything.
He can shoot.
Ooh.
It's 1 die.
Didn't this guy try to rally? Oh, wait. Oh yeah, that's right. You were in my no-no square.
Yes, Yeah, this is the consequence of him being in your no-no spray.
I will shoot at you.
That's...
It's going to hurt a lot.
So it's two half to one.
Can they... That's right, they can. Never
ha! Mind. Got him!
Yeah. No, you didn't.
No, I know.
Yeah. That's, they can't melee.
Correct. They can't melee, they can shoot. However, speaking of melees, I think there's one, correct?
Yep, right in the middle.
Here we go. Some horses. Some crazy Cossacks coming at four, six. 4 to 6, but Ron rerolls all of his hits. Oh, mercy.
Three
there. Three there. Ron, you got to roll all three.
Ooh, if you can roll all three.
Can he do it?
Not four.
Not four.
Yes!
No.
Cossacks! Yes!
Two. That causes him two.
But the Cossacks gotta run 6 inches.
Yep. The Cossacks will not.
Goodbye. I leave now. My planet needs me.
6 inches.
He wants to
I go back to my friends.
He wants to go back to
friend.
I was gonna say he wants to go back all the way. Alright, and Velker, your last chance for this evening to get those reinforcements on, one or a two.
Oh.
Again the three.
Had it been 1 second later.
Mm.
Ugh. Or a millimeter.
That
height.
Takes us to turn 14. Turn 14. Some mo dice for Ron's last turn, please.
Oh, yes.
Commence.
Napoleon's going over to the guard.
Whoa, he rides all the way over here.
You know what? No, we're staying on the right.
He rides all the way over here. What are you doing? What are you doing to my dog?
All right, that's two. Mm-hmm. All right, going to the Republican Guard. The Republican Guard. Going to the guard, French guard.
Kind of concerned about you, man. I knew where you were going. All right.
Wow. See? F for being up to five. All right. Prepare.
Mm-hmm. Oh, prepare, sorry. I realized you were not saying there. You were saying prepare. Having thought the better of that whole situation.
Back up!
You can only go three that way unless you're turning around.
I know.
Yes, run, Senor Pussycat. Run.
Wow. Having thought the better of the present situation. Interesting.
That's one, two, three, four. If I prepare them, I can still shoot, right?
Yep.
Oh, wait a minute. They're not shooting at anybody anyway. No one's in range. What am I talking about?
One, two, three, four, six.
Six. Velker, how's he doing?
You're good.
That's going to be marked as individual.
Oh. So that's
eight.
Eight. Velker, eight.
Eight is good.
Keep going.
Ten.
Ten?
Ten is it.
That's all. All right. Cannon fire, the one gun.
Reloading.
Finally.
Thought that might be going on. That's done. You now have three shots. Musketry.
This guy.
I don't think you have that choice.
I'm pretty close to you.
Oh, yeah. I guess I got to shoot. All right. Yep, then here.
Two dice,
shoot
no bonus.
Me and my horses.
Two dice, no bonus.
Why two?
You're shooting at horses.
Oh, that's right. Keep forgetting about the damn horses. And garnet horses. Go center.
I suppose that would have to be in range. Two dice with a bonus. No, no bonus. You're shooting at horses. Two dice, no bonus. Left.
No matter. Right. East guard.
Yep.
Grenadiers.
I can't imagine that those guys are even. I'm just checking on the... Yeah, I think that's the better shot, no matter what. So that's five with attached artillery, six, halved, three with a bonus. Unless that is 3 inches, right? Yeah. So, three with a bonus.
And these grenadiers against...
Yep, them fellers there.
These guard.
What's their current... Oh, this is full strength. Eight. No bonus. This is nasty.
Not bad. You rolled three threes, two twos,
considering,
and one.
Considering they're punching at each other at that kind of close range, that's ugly.
You rolled 1-1, 2-2s, and 3-3s. Wow.
Okay, that's all the melee fire here. How about down here? He went. Is that it? Are we good? Are we done?
Yeah, I'm looking. I think that should be it.
I don't know why it took me that long for it to dawn on me what those dragoons are doing in the trees.
They're hiding is what they're doing.
Yeah. So, interesting. Our morale should still be tied at 7, correct?
Yeah.
So correct. Let's remind ourselves that it just turned 15.
And it is Velker.
Which is Velker's turn, 15, as we return next time. So, the other thing I will observe, remember, we went into this battle with the score 7-2, correct? As things now stand, it's 6-3. Because...
Hey, Jim, before you...
Yeah.
Oh, I'm sorry. Go ahead.
I was just going to say the big thing over here is Kaltenbach has fallen, been taken from Velker, even though he's still fighting around it. It is still now, so it's 6-3, so Velker does still have the advantage as things go. What's up, OJ?
Just a couple of things in the chat there. John Pfeiffer was asking a scheduling question.
Oh.
Are we looking at Severdino 9-5 separate from Borodino on 9-7? Also, 9-6 is Denowitz would make things busy. I think he's asking what's your plans for the next few days.
Yeah, it's not the next few days. That's in October, if I'm looking correctly. Wow, this is...
Oh, he says 9-5. Isn't that September 5th?
Oh, my gosh. Oh, my God. That's right.
Okay.
Oh, my goodness. That's so correct. That Velker and I have to build some stuff. You're absolutely right. We're going to have to get together and pound out, see what is 9-2 today. That's right. 9-5 is the bloodiest day. It's the Battle of Borodino. I'm not quite sure what we're going to do for that one. I will let it be known. I was going to say this is sort of my personal protest against the fact that GMT has not released the epic, the LGB set, which includes a Borodino fight. There is no proper Borodino epic battle in Commands and Colors Napoleonics, and that makes me super, super angry. So let me take a look and see what scenarios they do have in the Russian set. That's right, they've got the four different battles. Only one, though. Only one is on the 5th, is the crazy part. And that's the Borodino Redoubt. We'll probably do the two Redoubt battles, just to say we got those in and honored Borodino in the proper way and build all those things. Because I don't think the other ones are there, right? Right? I'm good? Yeah, so we've got... And when is... Now that you're doing that to me, when is Denowitz? I love the fact that we have friends that are doing... That's right. And that's right. It is three... Velker?
Yes.
Three straight days.
It's
Borodino Redoubts, Denowitz, and then another Borodino Redoubts battle.
Mm-hmm.
Three straight days of battles.
Mm-hmm.
Epic? No, they're all our regular size battles.
Yeah, I think somebody's wife and mother was offering to let you use the dining room table, and that she would video the whole thing if you did it on the actual tabletop and not just on TTS.
It's been a long time, and I'm one of those people, and I don't know if Jeff is still around. I noticed he does one of the heretical things. He stands his Commands and Colors blocks up, and that is wrong. You lay them flat. It is wrong to stand them up. You hear me? Wrong. And anybody who says differently is also wrong.
Wait. All the screenshots I see on GMT, they're standing up.
And you know what those people are, Mike? Wrong.
The game designers?
I've asked Richard Borg. I have asked Richard Borg, and his answer to that question is he typically no longer plays with blocks because he has so many minis.
There you go. Hey, one other thing. Haz was asking about Velker's cavalry clear over on the Velker's left there that was going around the building there along the edge of the table.
Oh, them, yeah.
He was asking if they were partially off the table.
They are. I won't dispute that, but the problem is it's my bases. I'm getting away from these beveled bases because between this thing and this, I agree. I'm not playing, I just won't play a game of millimeters that way. If this base wasn't beveled, it would be the right size. Yeah, that's the thing.
I told him you allow a little bit of fudging there.
And the other thing is, had I been paying closer attention, I would have made absolutely sure that Kaltenbach gave enough room for one base to pass. Because if you look at one of the things that Sam says in the setup rules for these battlefields, it's impressionistic, but it's not like it's supposed to be hard tucked up here in this corner. I definitely would have left room for a base to pass around it. So that's why I judged that way. But that's a fair question. I was worried about it myself. Good question. So it's 6-3, gentlemen, as we head into the around the halfway turn. This has been a very, very fine Wednesday Night Warfare. I enjoyed watching it a lot. I thought it played out very interesting.
Definitely. I do have a question.
Yeah, what's that?
Say if I knock... I'm just not predicting, but say if I do knock his morale all the way down, does that mean I automatically get that city?
Yes. No, you automatically win.
That's what I thought. Okay.
Yeah, if you manage to take his... If the first way of winning is to destroy your enemy's morale.
If that doesn't work, then
it goes to... If that doesn't work, it goes to VPs.
Right.
You know, so it's... That's, as you all saw in the game between Mike and Zeke, it actually did come to VPs. They did not manage to shatter each other's morale. So
I'm not saying we're going to be able to either, but...
Yeah, I don't know either. I mean, it's interesting. And one of the other things that Haz has talked about, and I've decided to be consistent because we started out that way, rally isn't a standard rule. Rally is intended to be... I don't know what is supposed to be the specific thing, but he's quite correct that if you read Blucher, the rules, it says it's supposed to be built into a scenario and being situational. Now, I used it because all the old Meldrum games use it. You know, there isn't a one of them that doesn't. And it does have a slight, and I stress slight, effect of lengthening the game. You know, I don't think it's... Now, admittedly, especially with musketry and cannon fire, it's quite hard to get a hit. A hit means a lot. And so getting a hit back on a mere 3-6, but by the same token, you're spending an individual action, you're spending 2 points, you're not doing anything with that unit, and you're putting it in the back. So I think it kind of balances, but I think it's an interesting discussion. I
kind of like that rule, the rally rule, though, because first you got to get out of the fight first.
Right, right. To me, it makes sense that you're, okay, guys, go over here. Because if you look at where you guys are rallying, it's not like you're right up in each other's face, especially when you bear in mind that at this scale, 12 inches is a mile.
Right.
You know,
I kind of like the rally
So you're
rule.
A half a mile apart from each other. That's pretty dramatic. So let's, before we quit, before we all head out and go to sleep and get some rest, let's say hello to Blucher. There he is. It was his day today on Twitter. For some bizarre reason, a group of academics decided to turn today into Marshall Blucher Day on Twitter. And we were very happy,
hello,
by happy accident, to have been a part of it. In any event, thank you, Ron. Thank you, Velker. And
thank you, Jim.
Thank you so much for everybody that hung out and watched. As was pointed out, we're going to have a lot of gaming coming up. We have a day off, and then we're going 3 solid days plus Saturday night fights. So we're going to have a lot of wonderful Napoleonic games and wonderful other games. So we hope you all tune in and enjoy us. And by the way, let me also say, we are now at 510 subscribers. 510 crazy people that want to come together and watch people play war games, and I think that's awesome. So anyway,
that's fantastic.
So for Dalinore and for for Dalinore and for Velker and for myself, thank you so much for watching. Please take care of yourselves and one another.